So here we are having the voltage source. Okay. So voltage source la if we so manakuna directions this. Okay. So voltage source we are having the ID. Okay. That is current. So DC current is both directions. That is load to source, source to load, bidirectional, as well as DC power. So DC power is having the bidirectional. Okay. Now here active power and reactive. So active and reactive powers also in the bidirectional in the voltage source converter. Okay. Now if you take the current source converter. Okay. So in the current source converter, we having the current direction, that is the DC current direction, we'll having the only one direction. Okay. And DC power direction will having the either unidirectional or bidirectional. Okay. Based upon the operation. And here active power, reactive power direction will have to see. So that will be in the directional based upon the operation. Okay. So what is the operation, that is the inverted mode or rectifier. Okay. Based on the operation here, reactive power, active power direction will be changed. Okay. So here while thyristor switching on off, that is at what time so thyristor will be switched on. Okay. At what time thyristor will switch off. Okay. That will be same in the voltage source as well as current source, but small difference will be there. Okay. While switching on operation. Okay. So here main thing is that, so we have the different type, that is the diode rectifier and thyristor line commutated current. So we have the different types now. So in that one, what is the main that is which one is very suitable for our applications of the transmission lines. Okay, that we need to know for that one. So mainly based upon the operation limitations, why we are, so we are mainly choosing the voltage source converters as a operation of the in the flexible AC transmission system. Okay. So why we are taking the voltage source converters in the flexible AC transmission system. Okay. So we have to know that. So we have to comparison is there. Okay. That comparison from that. So we can easily know the why we are going for the voltage source converter of the, okay, why we are not using the current source converter in the practical way. Okay. So we have the differentiation in between the voltage source converter and current source converter. Okay. First, if we take the current source converter, so in the current source converter, okay, let me consider in the current source converter direction. Okay, so in the current source converter, direct current always one polarity. Okay, so let us consider the current source converter, the direct current, okay, current, okay, DC current is has only one polarity, and the power reversal take place through the reversal of the DC voltage polarity. Okay. So in the previous, I've said that the current direction will having the only one polarity, right? Okay. There we go. And whereas the, in case of the, okay, that thing is, in case of the voltage source converter, the DC voltage is having the one polarity. Okay. But the power reversal take place. Okay, so here, so power reversal take places through the reverse of the current polarity. Okay, so here are the one polarity. So current source converter also in the one polarity, and power take place through the reversal of the DC voltage. Okay, so that is the, if considering the voltage source converter, so voltage source converters are having the current polarity having the one polarity, but power reversal take places through the reversal of the voltage. So, okay, power reversal take place through the voltage polarity. Okay, but in case of voltage source converter, it will having the power reversal take place reversal of current polarity. Okay, so based upon the reversal of current polarity. Okay, one. Now another one. So if you having the differentiation, so conventional thyristor based converters. Okay, so if you considering the conventional based converters, so being without turn off capability, okay, being the without turn off capability can only current source. Okay, so can only be the current source converter. Okay, turn off capability. And whereas the turn off device based, okay, so if you considering the voltage source and turn off based converters can be the either current source or voltage source. Okay, based upon applications. Now if we consider the diode based converter, okay, if we considering the diode based converters, okay, so it having the lowest cost converter. Okay, so it having the lowest cost whatever the current source curve, if you have the diode based, that we have the lowest cost. If we control the active power, okay, so if we control of the active power by the converter, it is not required. Okay, so if control of active power by is not, okay, at what time we have to use the diode converter, that is when only we don't having the control of the active power, then we can use for the current source converter. But if you having the same application, that is the diode based converters, all right, so same application, if you use the voltage source converter, that is the very expensive. Okay, that is a very expensive due to the operation. Okay, that will be very expensive in case of the voltage converter. Okay, now if we leading, so we have if the leading reactive power is not required. Okay, well, so whatever the leading reactive power is, okay, if the not the conventional based current source converters are, okay, if you're not using if you are not focused on the reactive power control, so that will be, then we can use the current source converter because it is a low cost. But when we need the controlling of active power, reactive power, okay, so we have to go for the voltage source converter because it will having the some cost. Okay, so having the cost, if you don't need the reactive power component, but we can control the active power, okay, so that will be very cost in the voltage source converter. Okay, so we can say that what all the voltage source converters are there, okay, compared to the current source converter, it will having the cost based upon the applications. Okay, now in the current source converter does not having a high short circuit current. Okay, this one. So one thing is that in the current source converter does not have high short circuit current, but you have having the voltage source converter having the very high short circuit current. And another thing, so let will take another aspect, that the ratio, okay, the rate of rise of fault current, okay, whatever the rise of fault current then during the external or internal fault, okay, whatever the external, so that will be limited by the DC reactor in the voltage current source converter. Okay, so by using the DC reactor, we are going to limiting by using the, okay, so by using the DC reactor, we are limiting the external and internal faults. Okay, well, in case of voltage source converters, we are using the capacitor discharge. Okay, so we are using the voltage source converter. Okay, in the voltage source converter, two whatever the external internal faults is there. Here, what we are using, the capacitor discharge. Okay. Now, if we take the 6 pulse current source converter, does generate the third harmonic voltage. Okay, so current source converter 6 pulse voltage. So it will does not generate the third harmonic, whereas in the voltage source converter, it will generate the third harmonic voltage. Okay. Now, if we consider the transformer primary circuit, okay. If we consider that transformer connected to converter or pulse, should, okay, so in the 12 pulse transformer connection, if you use the primary as a current source converter, then it will no need to connect of the series connection. But in case of old source converter purpose to convert, same purpose may be the connected in series for the cancellation of the harmonics. Okay, here what we have to connecting the to cancellation of the harmonics. Next, we have another aspect. So in the current converters, okay, the valves are not subjected by the variation of the voltage with respect to the time. Okay, the valves are not subject to the variation, high voltage variation with respect to time. Okay, due to the presence of the AC capacitor. Okay, due to the presence of the AC capacitor. But in case of voltage source, it can be available. Okay. So it can withstand the high voltage variations with respect to time in the voltage source converter. Okay. Now, we have another differentiation. The AC capacitors, okay, whatever the AC capacitors is for required for the current source converter, okay, can be quite large. Whatever the AC capacitor required for the current source converter, it will be very large and expensive. But in case of old source converters, it will having the very cheap. Okay, if you are in the current source converter, we need the capacitor. Okay, if you use the capacitor, that will have the high expensive compared to the where we are in the voltage source converter. The size of the capacitor is very small and it will be very cheap. Okay, next we are having another aspect, that is continuous losses of the DC reactor. Okay, so we are considering that one is a DC reactor and the voltage source current source converter. Continuous losses in the DC reactor current source converter are much higher than the losses in the DC capacitor. Okay, so we have the high losses in the due to the DC reactor in the current source converter. We are coming to the voltage source converter, they are relaxed. That is having the less amount of losses we having the by using we are not using any DC reactor in the voltage source converter. So these are the differentiation between the voltage source converter and current source converter.